So hey guys, what's up? And in this video, we're going to see about 7 coolest Chrome features. As you can see on my screen, I have already uploaded a video on 7 coolest Chrome flags, but that was a previous version of the older version of Chrome of 2020 and 2021. It has to be great, right? It has to have some new coolest and interesting features that other browsers might have. But now we should enable it in Chrome, and those are hidden, and I will help you in enabling this. So without any further ado, let's get started with our video. And before that, if you're new to our channel, do hit like, share and subscribe to our channel. Till then, enjoy the video. So before getting started with our experiments with Google Chrome, we need to first go to Google Chrome, and in the address bar we just need to write chrome:// flags, and this will essentially take us to the experiment page of Google Chrome. So the first thing that tops in my list is the reader mode. Yes, you are right guys. And you have been listening about this feature in many other web browsers. Specifically, if I talk of, it's the Microsoft Edge and Mozilla Firefox, right? So now it's the time for Google Chrome to have this feature with. So let's enable this. So in the here, I can search for enable reader mode like so. And you can find here that enable reader mode. You have to just click on it, and you have to click on enable available in settings. So once you enable, it will prompt you to relaunch your site or the Google Chrome, right? So once you click on it, it will essentially relaunch, and you can, you know, like open a site. Let me open a site. So it's, let's say, for Geeks for Geeks. I am opening any of the articles of Geeks for Geeks. And once I open here, you can see a little icon here in the URL, right? And this is essentially the reader mode. So once I click on it, you will see it will convert it to the read-on mode, and I have enabled it in a dark mode. You can essentially click on this A letter icon, right? It will offer you different shades or the background that you want. You can have white, you can have yellow, yes. You can increase or decrease the font size as you can write, as you can see, right? And then you can also change your font family. So that's pretty much it in the read-on mode. The next feature is the smooth scrolling. So let's enable it, and I will type here smooth scrolling, and I will just click on it and hit on enable, and it will just prompt a relaunch option as it did in the previous ones. So once you click on relaunch, and it will essentially relaunch, and you will have your smooth scrolling enabled. What this smooth scrolling essentially will do is that it will just enhance your browsing experience, right? And it will have you feel more comfortable while scrolling through the web pages. Yeah. So now is the time to look in our new feature, that is tab scrolling. Yes guys, when you have multiple tabs open here, you can easily have an option that will help you in scrolling between the tabs and find you your specific desired tab that you want to search for. So let's enable that, and for that I will write here tab scrolling like so, and you can find here the tab scrolling option, and you can just click on this drop down and click on enable. And once you do that, after you hit the relaunch at the right bottom corner, you are done with this feature. Now the next thing that we have in our list is the parallel downloading. Now you can, or you have like seen that when you download multiple files on Google Chrome, it seems a bit slower, right? So how can you optimize that? We have an option in developer tools that is a parallel downloading, and this will enable the processes for downloading separate files, and to enable each new process for a separate download, right? This will optimize our speed in Google Chrome. So now let's enable it, and when I type parallel, and you can see there is an option of parallel downloading, and once I click on this drop down and hit enable, it will prompt you for the relaunch option, and once you click on that, you are done with this feature now. Now the next feature that we're going to see is over the cards to see the transparent view of the tab, right? What I mean by that is when I hover on this, you are essentially seeing a short span or a short information about this tab, but when we enable it, we'll see a different look when I hover on the tab, right? So just enable that. So let's enable that. So how can you do is that we can just write here hover card images like so, and I will just click on enabled. So once we do that, we'll have a prompt of relaunching, and when I hit on relaunch, you can essentially see that it relaunches, and yeah, When I'll now hover over this, you can see what it shows. It shows some content here, right? So it is not visible now because it's not loaded. Let me just reload it and you will now see it, how it actually looks like. So once you can see this site has loaded, and when I hover over this, you can see this is what I was talking about, the card hover image, right? Now the next thing that is in our list is the PDF presenter mode. Now what this PDF presenter mode essentially does is that in the previous version of Chrome, it doesn't have the option to present your PDF files. Now in the new Google Chrome and the developer version that we're going to enable right now will give you the support to present your PDF. So let's enable this right now. So I'll type here presentation PDF. And yeah, you can see here, this is the PDF viewer presentation mode. And once you click on this drop down and click on enable, it will be enabled. And once you click on relaunch, yeah, it will relaunch and I will show you what I mean by presenting it, right? So now I'll click on this and this is my PDF that is opened here. As you can see here, now I'll click on these three dots. And once I click on this present, you can see it actually presents us the PDF. Now last but not the least, it's my personal favorite, and this feature you can find in the browsers like Mozilla Firefox and Brave especially. What they claim is that they upgrade the connections to HTTP, and many of the users I have seen, they use an extension that is HTTPS secure. But guys, you don't need any of this because Chrome developers has this feature in them. So let's enable that, and for that I can write here HTTPS secure, right? And something like this HTTP secure, I think I can write here for upgrade HTTPS. This is the feature that I was talking on, and basically what this does is that it will enable the HTTPS upgradation connection in your device, right? What this will do is it will automatically upgrade your URLs to HTTPS if it finds the records in its HTTPS servers, right? So yeah, this is a cool feature that you can enable. So once I click on this drop down, you can hit on enable, and once you relaunch it and you are done with this new feature, and yeah, you don't need any extension, neither do you need Brave's feature. Yeah, so that's it for today's video, and hope you guys enjoyed a lot and learned a lot of content. For more interesting videos like this, make sure like, share and subscribe to our channel, and definitely you can check my other videos in my channel. So till then, stay safe, stay tuned.